In June 2025, Airtable made a big announcement sweeping across their entire organization that all of the plans on Airtable now include AI, and they've named their AI builder Omni. You can consult with Omni on your data in Airtable and even have Omni build your data solutions for you. We're talking both back-end formulas, automations, and interfaces in Airtable, all of them built by Omni. So in this video, I'm going to show you some best practices in how to build new Airtable solutions using Omni, which is available on all Airtable plans. If learning more about this is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Airtable is at the front of that. We are almost always building in Airtable, at least with a back-end database, oftentimes with automations and interfaces as well, so that our clients can get better no-code solutions faster and cheaper. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you Airtable's newest Omni, their AI tool that can now build back-end automation and interfaces. But before we get to that, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you're new to Airtable, I've put the basics out in a free crash course. I'm going to walk you through all the different components of Airtable so that you can get up to speed and really understand what Airtable is all about. Grab my free training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and I'll be sure to include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We're going to build something from scratch. We're going to say create. And now, regardless of what plan you're on, you are going to see Omni right here. To build an app with Omni, this is the AI that you can use to build a custom app tailored to your workflow. So let's make that selection. And here is what we kind of see as a general, you know, just starting point. We can, of course, go through some suggestions here. Change up suggestions. This is going to give us some of the more common different toolings that are used within Airtable. So you could add these prompts if you wanted to build your own thing. But let's say we're just going to do a really high level CRM. Now, we've done tons of CRMs on our channel before with Airtable. So there's a lot of content out there, a lot of resources for you. But what I want to point out is that this time we're going to build the entire thing from scratch using Omni. So we're going to simply call it out. We need a CRM that tracks, let's say, clients as they relate to accounts or companies. We also want to track interactions along with potential deals. And so this is not necessarily the best first prompt, but what I'm trying to get at here is that we can build this iteratively, meaning that we can, you know, take a first pass at it, start building, get that going in the background, which you see happening right now live on my screen. And then from here, what we're going to do is get into adding things on and then ultimately analyzing the data underneath. All of this is now available with Omni, Airtable's AI co-builder. So it's coming in right now. We can actually see that it is building out the different tables, and it's making a lot of sweeping assumptions, of course, right? I mean, you can see that we've got clients, accounts, interactions, and deals. These are the things that I called out when I put my initial prompt together. But in terms of what Omni is building out for us, you know, it's making a lot of assumptions in terms of how these things are related. It might not get it right every time, so we might need to go back in and make edits and whatnot. But here it is. That is all now built, and it came together in what? Less than 90 seconds, probably. The CRM system app is what it's named it, and it's designed to manage and track client relationships, including client details, associated accounts, interactions, and potential deals. Now, this is for internal use at Gap Consulting Group because that's the workspace that I'm building out of. Now, really quickly, I just want to pause and say this is a great first step, right? In the previous years of using Airtable, we would have had to build this by hand, and it would have taken some time. Even if we knew exactly what we were building, it takes time to click into every single thing, and we don't have to do that anymore. We don't have to go in, manually build these fields. We can just tell Omni to do it. And so here's what it's saying. It's actually giving us a prompt and saying, hey, to finish setting it up, why don't you take a quick tour? So we can click here and take a tour. We can customize the app name and color. We can continue building. We can remove sample data, or we can publish and share it with our team. So that's a really good first start, right? Let's go ahead and continue building the app though. And so this is going to bump us down to the bottom here, and we can add new prompts. We've got some follow-ups also that come from Omni. So it says, you know, for example, we could create a dashboard for deals. We could create a calendar for interactions. This is really helpful stuff, but not something I need for our purposes. I also want to highlight, though, that not only did we build that data layer back end, we also built the interfaces front end. And this is, by the way, a new look for Airtable. I've heard that this is rolling out to people's accounts. Heard some mixed signals. Some people are a little resistant to the change. Personally, I think it's pretty snappy. I like the new look. I feel like it looks a lot more modern and, you know, up to date. But, you know, you'll be the judge, and let me know in the comments what you think about the new look as well, and if it's already rolled out to your account or not. But up here at the top is where we're seeing the different components of Airtable now, and Omni kind of has that left panel when we're, you know, in build mode. And I've got the data layer here. These are the tables that Omni built. Automations, Omni didn't actually build any automations, so, you know, we didn't ask him to yet. And then we've got our interfaces. So I do want to highlight, because I talk to many, many clients every week that are still not using interfaces. This is best practice for where people will access your app. So when you launch your app to your team, you don't want them in the data layer. This is where they're going to delete things. They're going to break formulas. You're going to lose data, and it's going to get messy. Keep people in interfaces, because here you can lock down what they see. You can give them specific permission to only edit certain things or only click into certain records, as you see here. They can only go in and edit what you give them permission to. They can only see what you give them permission to. So I strongly recommend that if you're not already leveraging interfaces, Omni takes away any excuse you have. So build interfaces, and you can even ask Omni to build new ones for you. So for example, let's jump in here and look at our accounts, right? So we've got these account lists, and we've got deals, and sure enough, Omni already put deals into a Kanban view, which makes a ton of sense. But let's say we want to get our deals in a list view. So we can ask Omni to do this for us. We don't even need to know the ins and outs of how to build an interface. It's going to help if you want to come back and make changes, but you don't need to know it to get started. So right here in Omni, right, I'm going to say, please build an interface for our deals that shows all deals in the open status, or I'll in parentheses say not closed, and let's rank them in order of deal value. Please make this a list view. A list view is a type of view. In Airtable, we have a number of different types of views. This particular one, as I mentioned, is a Kanban. We can do stuff in calendars. We can put things in lists or grids or galleries or card views. So there's a lot of different ways that you can slice your data. But what I want to highlight is that Omni is building the interface for us, and sure enough, putting these deals together. If I were to click into this, over here on the right side, we're going to see the different components that Omni has preloaded for us. So you can see that Omni is grouping by the deal stage. We can see that, let's see if they're, yeah, so they've made these fields visible. What I don't see is, you know, I asked to only see those things that are not closed. We've got deals that are closed won, deals that are closed lost. So this is where it might be a little helpful if you know something about the interfaces. You can go in and make additional adjustments. So I can click here as an example and apply a filter to the deal stage. And I'll say, is any of, and then I'll select just the stages that I care about. I'll omit the closed stages because maybe I want to look at this particular view that shows me anything that's kind of still in the pipeline, right? But my point is that Omni did most of the lift for us, and then at the end we can come in and make those small tweaks. And perhaps the best part is this. Let's go ahead and publish our app. Let's publish the whole thing. right? We've already seen how Omni can build this from the ground up. We've seen how Omni can then add new interfaces. And similarly, we could have had Omni add new tables as well. But here's what I really want to share with you. Now, bear in mind, we have sample data here, but Omni is now available down here. And by the way, we can close this down, right? Bottom right corner in the new setup, the new Airtable layout, here's Omni, and we can pop Omni open, and we can actually analyze the data that we have in our database. So imagine how useful this can be for you. If you have your data in Stripe or QuickBooks or some other source, and you bring it into Airtable, and you don't even really know how to perform data analytics yourself, but now you can ask the question right to the AI bot, right inside of the tool that you're using to store your information. This is quite honestly game-changing. Let's take it out for a spin. So we can say something like, perform some quick analysis on the health of our deal pipeline. And let's toss that in and see what Omni says. Now, again, we have sample data here. The more data you have, the better the results that you're going to get from Omni will be. But let's see what it says right now. So here we go. Wow. Okay. It's coming out hot, coming fast. Let's see what the final output is. All right. So I'm scrolling back up. Deal pipeline health analysis. Below is a quick analysis of your deal pipeline. Number of deals by stage. This shows how deals are distributed across stages. And so Omni is using the actual data that's in our, you know, in our sample right now. This is actual live data for our situation. And here's the total deal by stage, giving us a little bit of a breakdown. Here's the average deal value by stage. So this doesn't make a ton of sense or isn't significantly valuable because, again, we have sample data. But imagine that you have thousands of records that you're analyzing right now. This is something that you used to pay a data analyst $80,000 or more a year to do for you. And now it's right here, right in the bottom corner of your solution. That's pretty powerful stuff, right? And beyond that, we can ask even more prying questions. For example, what fields should I add to my deal flow to allow me to perform even better data analysis? These are the questions that if you start leaning into with AI, this will really revolutionize your Airtable solutions. Because when you ask what you don't know, the truth is we all don't know what we don't know. But when you ask AI to help you figure that out, this is where you can unlock the cheat codes, right? So, you know, right off the rip, AI is saying, or Omni is saying, we need to track the source of your deal so that you can track how a deal got into your pipeline. This will enable analysis of sources and which of those generate the highest value. We need to do things like probability to close so that we can perform some sort of analysis on the actual health of a pipeline. We need to set up number three, owner assigned sales reps, date entered current stage. So we're tracking, when something entered the stage, when we lost a deal, track the reason. What is the product or service type? I mean, these are all fields that we could very easily have Omni add to our database, and we would now have richer data that would allow us to grow and scale our business even better. So my biggest tip to you, yes, Omni is amazing. It can build your database, your interface, your automation. That's awesome. It can perform analysis. Very cool. But the most important thing is it can tell you what you don't already know. And that, my friend, is how you're going to grow and scale and perform your job to the next level. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. I know this stuff is wild. It is changing every day, and I hope you're leaning into it and really empowering your workflows with the amazing new features Airtable made available. That's it for this video, but if you got some value from it, we would love a thumbs up. Please subscribe to the channel. Of course, if you have questions we didn't get to, swing by our website because we have a ton of valuable resources for you. But most importantly, keep on building.